Welcome to this lecture on isometric projection. In this video, we are going to see isometric view of cone. So this is a problem which is given. Draw the isometric view of a cone of base diameter 50 mm and axis length 60 mm. Resting on HP on its base, right? What are the given datas? It is a cone, base 50, axis 60, base is resting on HP. Just draw the isometric view. What are the steps to be followed? First, we need to draw the simple position. Next, we need to give the dimensions and notations. Then we need to start the isometric projection. These are the steps. Okay, first we would like to draw the reference line, mark XY, BP and HP. Since the cone is resting on its base on HP, so the true shape of the base will be seen only from the top view. So we need to first draw the top view first, right? Okay. To draw the top view, bring your scale, just draw a 50 mm line like this. Then you have to mark center 25 mm. Take your compass, take a radius of 25 mm and complete the circle. Then segment this circle into 4 equal parts by drawing a line here. So now we have segmented the circle into 4 equal parts. Next step, just draw a projection line from each corner like this, right? Then we need to draw a axis length here. Why here? Means since the axis is coming from this projection line only and not from this or not from this. So just bring your scale here, just draw 60 mm line. Since it is axis line, you should represent with dash and dotted line. It is not a continuous line, just understand. Then you just complete the cone. The generator should be dark and the base should be dark like this, right? After this, we are completed. The next step is we need to give the dimensions, right? Here we are giving the dimensions. As diameter is 50 millimeter, then the height is 60 millimeter. The next step is we need to give the notations for the top view. So I am giving A, B, C, D. Always the notation should be in the anti-clockwise direction. So I am starting from here, A, B, C, D, and the center is O. And I am going to look this object from this direction. So I am getting A, B, C will be visible, whereas D is hidden. So that's why this D dash will be represented within the bracket, right? Okay. So now we have completed the top view and front view. We have completed the step number one, that is drawing simple position is completed. The next step, we need to draw the isometric projection. To draw the isometric projection, I am just enclosing this top view within the box like this. Just enclose the circle in a box. After this, just draw another reference line. Choose any point in the line, bring your protractor, mark 30 degree on both sides, here and here. Okay. The next step, your scale. The next step is bring your scale and just draw a 50 mm line, right? Then bring your scale here and draw another 50 mm line, and then see here you have to move your scale parallel to this line. This is very important. You have to move your scale parallel to this line and mark 50 mm and draw a line. Similarly, bring your scale and move parallel to this line and complete this 50 mm. So we have completed the box now. Now we are going to construct the circle. We are going to construct the circle here. For that, I am going to follow the four center method. You know what is mean by four center method. So before starting this four center method, I am just draw a line from these two diagonals in order to find the center of this box. This is the center of my box. Yes. After getting the center of the box, we need to mark center for this four lines. We have four lines in the box. We have four lines. For each line, we have to mark the center. That is from here to here, 25 millimeter. Similarly, we need to follow for all the three lines. So the center is marked. The next step, from here, we need to draw a line like this. From this diagonal, we need to draw a line like this. Okay. So how to draw the circle? It's very simple. Take your compass. So the center is this point and the radius is this line. Center and radius, draw a arc. Similarly, this is a center and this line is radius, draw a arc up to this. Next, this point is center and this short line is my radius and draw the arc. Similarly, this point is my center and this line is my radius and just complete the circle. So we have completed the circle. Next, we know the axis length, that is 60 millimeter, and we marked the center already. So bring your scale and just draw a 60 mm axis line. So we have completed the axis line. The next step, we need to draw the generators, extreme generators here as well as. So to draw the generator, just draw a line like this, right? Since this portion is not visible for us, only this portion will be visible when we are looking from this direction. So we need to dark this portion alone like this. No need to dark this, it is actually hidden, so no need to dark, right? So after making this, we need to give this isometric angle as 30 degree. So now we have completed the isometric view of the cone. So you just write in your drawing sheet all the dimensions are in mm. What are the dimensions we have used for this problem? It is all in millimeters. So this is a isometric view of a cone. The step one is drawing the simple position. Step two is draw the dimensions and the notations. The step three is isometric view of a cone. So that's all about this lecture. Hope this lecture will give a step-by-step procedure to solve the isometric view of a cone, and thanks for watching.